In this lesson, we are going to construct a Raptor flowchart to find the average of a given set of numbers. In the course of constructing the flowchart and testing it, we will cover two important concepts. One is looping, the second one is input redirection. Let's first talk about input redirection. When we have to test a program with test data, we usually input the data through the keyboard. If the data is large, this can get tiresome, especially when we have to run the program several times. We could save a great deal of labor if we could make the program go to an input file where the data is stored, as opposed to having us input the data every time the program is run. So for example, in the case of finding the average of a given set of numbers, we could have the input data stored in a file and make the Raptor flowchart read from the file instead of from the keyboard. This process is called input redirection. So to redirect the data, what we need to do is create a text file with all the numbers for which we need to find the average. So suppose we want to test the program with three numbers, 3, 4, and 8. So the average would be 5. What we will do is we will create a file with 3 in the first line, that is the first number, 4 in the second line, and 8 in the third line. That is, one line is dedicated for one piece of input. After creating this document, we need to save it as a text file, and then we will use a special symbol in Raptor called redirect input to make it go to this file and read from there. We are going to save this in a file called data1.txt. Let us now create a Raptor flowchart for computing the average of a given set of numbers. In order to accomplish this task, we need two variables. One is to find the sum of all the input numbers, and the second one is a count of the number of numbers. Once we have these two, we can divide the sum by the count and get the average. So we create two variables, count set to 0 and sum also set to 0. Now it is time to start reading in the data. Remember, we are going to redirect the input. We are going to make the flowchart read from the file data1.txt. For that, click on the call symbol and put it into the flowchart. And here you type in redirect input and give the name of the file. It is data1.txt, and say done. Now we need to read the input numbers one by one until there is no more input. So we have to read a number, accumulate sum, add one to count, read a number again, add that number again to sum, increment count by 1, and keep on doing this until there are no more numbers. So we are going to execute the same piece of code. Read a number, accumulate sum, increment count. Read a number, accumulate sum, increment count many, many times until there is no more input. So the same piece of code is going to be repeated over and over again. So for that, we need what is called a loop. So we click on loop and put that over here. Now you can see that we have two symbols, loop and a condition after that. This is going to determine whether the loop is going to end or not. You can see that this is like a decision box. Only thing is, this is going to be controlling a loop instead of just a selection. So if the condition is true, we are going to exit. If the condition is false, we are going to repeat the loop. So whatever we want to repeat must come between this symbol called loop and this decision box. So between these two, we must read a number, accumulate sum, and increment count. So let us do that. Let us first read a number. So we need to read a number. We don't really need to prompt anything because we are going to redirect the input, but the number itself should be read into a variable called number. So we have get number here. We need to have a statement to accumulate sum. So we need an assignment where we set sum to the value of sum plus the number that we just read in. And we also need to increment count. So count will be set to count plus 1. So that takes care of the loop. So within the loop, we'll be getting a number, sum will be set to sum plus number, and count will be incremented. But what about repeating? When are we going to repeat? Or in other words, when are we going to get out? So we need to get out when there is no more input. So we type in here end of input. When there is end of input, this branch will be taken. If there is no more data, this branch will be taken. If there is at least one more piece of data in the file, control will go here. Now all we need to do is, once we have read all the data, we need to compute the average. So we need to find the average here. So average would be set to sum divided by count. It's done. Now, finally, we need to print the average. That is the end of the flowchart. Let's now run this flowchart to make sure that it will indeed run correctly by reading the numbers from the file data1.txt. You must also run the program using additional test data to make sure that it works correctly in all situations. So let's now run this program. You can now see that it has taken the input from data1.txt. The loop gets executed 3 times and the average is printed out as 5. So it is able to read the data from data1.txt. Please make sure that when you run the program, the file data1.txt is closed everywhere except in Raptor, and that it is stored in the same folder as the Raptor program. Otherwise, you will have to give the absolute path name of the file.